What's going on, guys? It's your boy again, back at it again with another one. Oh yeah. Oh. So today's video, right? It's not even really my video, but let me just give you a backstory on the video, all right? Three videos, four now. Anyway, so every year I go to Body Power, okay? It's a fitness exhibition in Birmingham. So every year I go there. Now there was this one year, I'm just walking around as I do, and I know that person. Like, I'm looking at this guy like, and I'm like, I know you, where do I know you? Now, you know when like, you could be in a foreign country, right? And you could actually see your mum, right? Because you don't believe your mum's there, you will literally walk past your mum because you're thinking like, why would she be? No, that's not her. Someone looks like her. You walk past it. Do you know what I mean? Because you're not expecting her to be there. So I'm looking at this individual and I'm like, no, I know you. Then it clicked. That's Obese to Beast. Now, when I say I was on YouTube for about a year, all right, you know, on and off on a different channel, not this channel here, on a different channel for about a year. And I started to release videos and I said to myself, I wonder if there's anyone like me doing similar content that are trying to appeal to a similar type of people, which is the overweight, obese, the people that want to lose weight, the people that suffer with depression and anxiety, all right? So I just kind of just typed in obesity, weight loss, you know what I mean? And see who is doing what I'm doing. And John Glaude popped up, aka Obese to Beast. So I was following this guy for a year, you know, and he was he's a very big inspiration, man. A very big inspiration. He's been doing his thing. He stayed true to where he's come from in the sense of his journey, you know. You know, at the end of the day, he's still living his life. He's still doing his things, but he always gives back and tries to help and assist and motivate and educate anyone that's overweight, obese, that's trying to lose weight, you know, that's trying to better themselves, right? So anyway, I saw him and I was like, oh my gosh, like, because genuinely he's been a hero to me for like over a year. So literally, I'm not even joking, I took my bag off and I'm just waiting in line, like, waiting in line, because there was like a little queue, like there was three or four people in front of me. So I'm just waiting in line, like, And I was shaking because I'm thinking, oh my gosh, this is actually the guy. Like, this is actually my hero right now. You know what I mean? Like, and I had a conversation with him. And he is the same exact guy you see on YouTube. If you haven't checked his content out or his channel out, Obese to Beast, right? Anyway, so I met him, introduced myself. I showed him my old picture of me. He was like, oh my gosh, you've done amazing, you know? And I said to him, listen, are you here for the weekend? He says, yes, I'm here for the weekend. So I says, listen, can I come back tomorrow and kind of ask you some questions on camera? And he goes, yeah, of course, I would love to do that. And deep down, I don't know, you know, sometimes people just say things. So look, the next day I loaded up my camera and I came, and as I said, listen, have you got time? You know what I mean? Like, because you know, he's a busy guy, like other people want to see him. So I asked him if he had time to kind of, you know, say some words on camera. I'm gonna ask him a few questions, and he obliged and he did it. But then I didn't do nothing with the footage, because when I played it back, the sound was horrible. But then I don't know what it was, recently I had another look at it and I thought to myself, you know what, he actually gave the interview, it looked like an actual Obese to Beast episode, and I feel like it will be selfish of me to keep it to myself. Here I am, I'm gonna share it with you guys. Let me know what you think. Also holler at him, let him know what you think. And yeah, he's from America, obviously I'm from the UK. Well, it should be obvious because of the way that I talk, you know. But yeah, he's from America, but either way, you know, same journey, same pain, same problems, you know, that anyone that is overweight or obese went through. So regardless of where you are in the world, we're all related in our struggles, all right? So yeah, check out the video, guys, and let me know what you think.
What's up, you guys? So my name is John, so more known as Obese to Beast. So I used to be 360 pounds. So that was me back in the day, and then I got down to 180 pounds was my lowest, and that's when I competed on stage. And now I sit around 200. So my biggest challenge when I was overweight was definitely the fact that, like, I felt like I wasn't living. Like, I felt like I was just kind of existing in life. And that kind of, it's hard to deal with, because, like, you just feel like the future doesn't look right. And at 20 years old, which is when I was at my heaviest, like, waking up and not being excited about the day, not being excited about next year, or being afraid, like, I used to be afraid to be alone in my house because I thought I was going to have a heart attack at 20 years old. So that was definitely the biggest challenge for sure. I would say by far the biggest challenge after losing the weight relationship with food. It is insane. Because, like, think about it like this. Being as big as I was, I ate everything. Like, food was my comfort. It was everything. And then losing the weight, I ended up developing, like, kind of a binge eating disorder. And in my head, food became the enemy. So I was always afraid of eating, afraid of food. And, like, I remember I used to, if I ate too much where I was full, I felt like I was failing. And, like, so struggling with that. And, like, that was years and years and years struggling with that. And I would say, it hasn't until been, like, maybe the past year that I've actually felt like I found that healthy relationship with food. And it is something that I feel like people don't realize how difficult it is. We're going from so big, trying to make a huge change. It's a big deal, and it was really hard. So for me, the click moment, it came when I was actually watching Miami Ink, which is a show all about tattoos. And at the time, I only had these two, right? And I always wanted more, like, on my body. But, like, I couldn't bring myself to get a tattoo on anywhere else just because I was so heavy. And, you know, I was like 20 years old, so if I got a tattoo, I wanted to show it off, right? But before that, I had actually been at a wedding, and basically, like, I remember I almost, like, passed out at the wedding, and I was really afraid of that, like, what was going on. But then the pictures came back from the wedding, and I saw those photos, and, like, I was absolutely devastated. But then fast forward about, like, 2 weeks after that was when I was watching that tattoo show, and a guy came on the show that had lost a lot of weight, and they basically asked him how to lose the weight. And the answer that he gave wasn't even that groundbreaking, but it was where my mind was at that time. Like, I decided, like, this is my fault, there's nobody to blame but myself. So I need to, the choices I'm making have got me to be obese. So the choices that I can make are what are gonna, you know, make me not obese. And it was right there, like, and with click moments, it's like one of those things that I wish I could just give to anybody, like, give you, but it's something that you just have to hide in yourself. It's something that, it could be a wedding, it could be pictures, it could be anything. It could be, you know, the birth of a child, you know, you're a parent now. Everyone's different, and, like, once you find that click moment, like, it can change your life.
Say thank you for Jean-Claude Obese to Beast for, you know, giving me his time to talk to me and, you know, do the interview, which hopefully someone out there benefits from. Do you know what I mean? Yeah, so Jean-Claude, I salute you, brother. All right, guys, so that's the video. I hope you enjoyed the video, guys. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, head over to Obese to Beast's channel, let him know where you came from, say hi, say you sent by Rick, and yeah.